For a long time, Skype was the preferred method to record a conversation for podcasting. You can still do that today, but there are much better ways to record high-quality audio and video. In this video, I'll show you how to record on Skype, and I'll give you an even better option that was made specifically for podcasters. If you do want to record on Skype, fortunately, Skype has made this a very easy process, but you won't get a high-quality recording. First, download Skype. There's a link to download in the description. Once you've created an account or logged in, create a new meeting and invite others by sharing the meeting link. Once your other party joins, click record. The recording will start and notify the other participants that you are recording. To stop recording, hit the record button again. When you end the call, the recording will be available to view and download in the chat section of your meeting. You can save it from here and it will save into your computer downloads. This is what your recording will look and sound like. You can see here that even with Steven's 4K camera, the video quality isn't the best. Skype offers poor video quality and compressed audio. The way many users get around this is by manually recording each side of the conversation, known as a double-ender recording. This means that you're recording your audio natively on your computer using something like Audacity or Adobe Audition, and your guest does the same. This way, Skype is just used to facilitate the conversation. You won't rely on internet connection for a high-quality recording, and your audio won't be compressed. The issue with this is that it puts more pressure on your guests to have technical expertise, and you as the host can't actually see what they're doing. If you want a video that looks and sounds like this, then you should use Riverside to record. Riverside is an online recording solution based off of the web, which means that your guests don't have to download any software to record. It works similar to a Skype call, but the platform records locally on both you and your guests' computers, meaning that you're not relying on internet connection for the final recording. At the end of the recording, you'll have separate uncompressed audio and video tracks for everybody involved in the recording. You can download these tracks separately, or you can choose to combine them and create your podcast on the Riverside platform. You can even choose to upload your recording directly to Spotify through Anchor, straight from Riverside. Riverside also has an app so that you and your guests can use your phone's high-quality camera and mic for a high-quality recording. With Riverside's free plan, you can get up to 2 hours of separate track downloads, but you'll also get unlimited combined track downloads, which is the same product that Skype gives, but Riverside will give it in higher quality. With the free plan, you can record up to 720p, but if you upgrade to the standard plan for just $15 a month, then you can record up to 4K video. So even though Skype is a long-standing app for making online calls, you can get much higher quality recordings when you switch to Riverside. We hope this video has helped you figure out if Skype is the right way for you to record, or if Riverside is a good alternative for your needs. If you learned something new, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. And before you go, subscribe to our channel and press that bell icon so that you never miss another video from the Riverside YouTube channel.